guys, welcome to Fash Mind. Today I'm here with a new type of dream catcher. It's a pom-pom dream catcher. I'm adding pom-pom to it. So for this, it's a medium size of dream catcher. So for this, I'm using a 19 centimeter ring. The ring comes in a 19 centimeter. The next step is to wrap this. To wrap, I'm using a normal knitting wool. For this, a thin normal knitting wool. It's a pom-pom dream catcher, so for this, for making pom-pom, I'm using the same wool in a gray shade, navy blue, and a white shade. Next, for the tassels, I'll be adding feathers. Feathers I've taken a gray shade and a white shade, and then beads. Beads also I've taken in a multi shade and a white shade. For the wrap tutorial, you can check my other videos. I'll be adding in my description box below. You can check with that. So as I told, I've used a thin wool in white shade for this because I want it to be thin. That's why I've used a thin wool for it. While adding the pom-pom, Dreamcatcher will look more beautiful. That's the reason I've used it. Now our second step is to make pom-pom. So I'm here with an easy way of making pom-pom. Like I'm used the help of a chair legs, like two legs of a chair. So first we have to make a knot, make a triple knot, a tight knot over there. And now we have to roll it. So my pom-pom is a small size. So I'm doing an 80 round of it. 80 round. If you want a thicker pom-pom, you can add up to 100 for a small pom-pom, 80 to 100. So the roll should be on top of the other. Do it very carefully in a tight way, up to 80 to 100 rounds. You can also check like how much you want in between, so you can stop it wherever you want it to be. Once you're done with the 80 rounds, the next step is to divide it. So this pom-pom is in 4 count in total. You can get 4 pom-pom. So take a thread and make a very tight knot. You can make at least 3 knots. It should be very tight. Before making the second knot, first we have to mark the right measurement, make a correct measurement, and then tie according to it. So there will be 4 pom-pom in total, small size pom-pom, so that you have to make 3 tie and then cut it according to it. So this is how our pom-pom will look. So this is not the final finish. There is 2 more steps to go to get a perfect pom-pom. So I'll be showing you 2 steps, like easy way to make a right pom-pom, to get a right pom-pom. So to get the right pom-pom, I'm using a help of a cardboard cutter. This is 2 centimeter in size. So first we have to mark the center portion, I mean where we get the tie. That's the center portion, I mean the back portion of a pom-pom, and then place the tie over there, and then place the cardboard cutout on top of it, I mean the back portion, and as well as on the front portion. Place the cardboard on the front portion. So now you can see the excess threads all over. Now we have to cut all the excess portion. Okay, now I'm done with the back and front portion. I've cut all the excess threads. Now we haven't finished the final look of it. So now we have to cut the rest two side, I mean the right and left side of your pom-pom. So place the pom-pom the same way what we did for the back and front. So place the other two side in the same way, and then keep your carbon cutters on both sides. So now you can see some excess threads. So now we have to cut all that. Have cut all the excess threads of a pom-pom. This is small size as I told, so I've used a 2 cm pom-pom. If you want a bigger size pom-pom, you can make a carbon cutter according to the length of your pom-pom, so you can get big pom-pom for that. So here is our pom-pom. I have did 3 white pom-pom and 3 gray and 3 navy blue in total. The navy blue is the one what I've shown. Next comes gray, that is 1 cm, like the carbon cutters is 1 cm, that's the length for that. And the white is same for the blue, that is 2 cm. So this white I'm doing a different method, like after doing the pom-pom just comb it using a comb, so you get another finishing for it. So make sure your wool should be very quality one, otherwise you won't get this finishing. Okay, now we have to make the loop for the hand. So this I'm using the same wool in white. So mark the measurement and cut it according to the length what you want for the hand. Now we have to make a knot at the edge. Make it triple knot or a double knot, whatever you feel safe with. Make it tight it proper. And then now you have to stretch it and see whether it's coming out. And now cut the excess threads, the excess portion. Now place the loop on top of the ring. Place it and take the knot portions towards inside of the other loop. Take it through the thread and then pull it, so you got the loop here. This is the perfect way of making a loop. After that, the next step is for the tassels. For the tassels, I'm using the same wool in white, and I'll be adding these beads what I've shot earlier, the multi-shade and the white beads. I'll be inserting this through it. Okay, now the third step is to add the tassels. For that, as I told, I've inserted 3 beads to the thread. So first one comes multi-shade and then 2 white. This is how I've added for all 7 threads. So first one we have to place it to the center, mark the center portion and then make a triple knot. My tassels comes in 7 count in total, 1 in center and 3 for each side. So, and I'm doing in a V shape. So mark the measurement and cut it according to it, and then hang it for the both side, and then place the beads in a V shape. So this is how it should be, the multi shade in a V shape, the first count, and the center 5 in V shape, and the down in a V shape. Now I'm gonna add the pom-pom. So for this I'm using a help of a hot glue. I'll be pasting glue on one side and then I'll attach it to the ring. First I'm starting with the white, so you can do according to the color. Once done with the pom-pom, the next step is to add the feathers to the tassels. So first I'm starting with the white feather. So for all this I'm using a help of a hot glue. I'll be pasting hot glue on the feather and then insert it through the bead. Just like this, insert it through the bead. I'm doing this for the first layer for the multi-shade and the second layer, the center one, for the 5 beads. Insert the same color for first layer and second layer in white. Thank you. now for the last round, the third V, I'm gonna add gray feathers. I'll be inserting gray feathers to the white beads. Now the last and final step is to cut the excess thread, the excess portions what we've got. Just cut it up, that's it. If you like my video, please do like, comment and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.